Hi guys, in this tutorial we will see how to debounce a push button. So let's get started. For this, you will need Arduino, jumper wire, 1K and 10K ohms resistor and LED. Do connection as shown in diagram. It is same as previous video, only changes will be done on program. Let us first understand what is bouncing in push button. When you push button, a piece of metal touches right and left side at the same time. It make contact and current will flow, but practically it won't happen. Suppose we push button, it touches right side first, then touches left side. Now current will flow, but it bounce at right side again, then comes to original position. It causes current flow and stop for milliseconds, which is not desirable for application which requires some task like alarm which makes sound once, but due to this bouncing button it produces sound twice. Because of bouncing it produces multiple signal. You can solve this problem by two ways: buy a push button which have very low bouncing so that it can be neglected. Second is software solution. We program the Arduino in such a way it will produce one signal when it is pressed. Now let's come to the programming part. Whole summary of this code is: at initially LED is on, and when we press the button for longer than 50 milliseconds, it will change the state and turn off the LED light. Define button pin and LED pin number. These are all state variable. LED state is high means initially LED will be on after running code. Button state variable monitor the button, either it is high or low. Last button state is set to low. It is necessary to know current and last state of button so that Arduino will send signal turn on or off LED. Unsigned long, which store large numbers but can't store negative numbers. These variables are used to track time. Debounce delay, which is set to 50 milliseconds. It is threshold value for confirming button is really pressed. We can increase or decrease this value. If we increase this value, suppose 1000 milliseconds, it will require to push the button for 1000 milliseconds, it will turn on or off the LED. In setup function, define pin mode for button pin as an input and LED pin as an output. Digital write will turn on the LED light because we have given LED state high. Now come to the loop function. We are defining new integer reading equal to digital read of button pin. It will read it is high or low. Suppose reading is high. Now on next line, if it is not equal to last button state, which is set to low, so this condition is true. Last debounce time will be calculated with millis. If millis minus last debounce time greater than debounce delay, it will execute two nested if condition. But let us assume it is not greater than debounce delay. It will skip two if condition. Digital write, LED state which is high, LED remain on. Set last button state equal to reading. Now again loop will start. Reading is equal to last button state, so this code will not execute. Debounce time will not calculate it. Now suppose it is greater than 50 milliseconds, it will again check button state. Reading is not equal to button state. It will set button state is equal to reading, that is high. If button state is high, it will switch LED state. LED state is high, but due to switching, it will become low. Now digital write will turn off LED light, because LED state is low. You can see when I press button, it turn off LED light. When I press again, it will turn on LED light. For more videos, please like and subscribe. Till then, keep learning, keep making.